famous film director, the Oscar-winning director, Satyajit Roy, once directed a cinema named Hirok Raja Deshe. In that cinema, the king used to say to his subjects, the more they learn, more they read, less they obey. This is the same policy of any autocratic ruler. And this is the policy which are followed by our present ruling government, Modi Sarkar. From the very first day, they launched a battle against the student community, the academic community. First we observed a huge budget cut. And if you see the figures, in 2014-15, they spent 0.6% of GDP on education. And now in 2018-19, they spend only 0.45% of GDP on education. And also, they are using three deadly weapons to implement their philosophy, which are commercialization, centralization, and communalization. We also observed in this period how they are trying to dismantle public education system. In the recent past, they are trying to shut down a huge number of schools in the states like Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Gujarat, in these places. In some places where we have our organization, SFI protested against their policies. In Maharashtra, this present BJP government compelled to roll back their decision as SFI demanded and fought for the rights of the students. And we also observed the exclusion policy of this BJP government. Now, we observe the third martyrdom day of Rohit Vemula. And now, the same policy is continuing right now. They are trying to attack a minority. They are trying to attack the SC-ST population of our country. We observe in the recent past also, they are also trying to shut down the tribal hostels also. Even existing condition of the existing tribal hostels, it is in a very bad shape. Recently, a survey was done by the CARD and SFI. We also cooperated with them. We observed that the pathetic condition of those hostels, tribal hostels, especially in the states like Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, in these places, and some places like in West Bengal also, a huge number of tribal hostels are shut down. And these are the policies, they are not giving money for education, and it is the reflection of their policy. At the same time, what is happening in higher education? We believe that education is the future. If you investing on education, you are investing in the future of our country. And what do you observe here in case of higher education also, they are trying to destroy the creative development, because their ultimate aim is to destroy the thought process. They are trying to destroy the reasons, rationality, and scientific temper. And now they are trying to close the scholarships. And now all over the country, the students are agitating for their scholarship. There is a fellowship hike movement going on in the elite, from the elite institutions to the state universities. Everywhere students are agitating. But what is happening in the recent past, we also observed they are trying to reduce the numbers for the scholarships, like MGNM scholarship, MANS scholarship, RGNM scholarship, which are provided for the marginalized students, for the SCST population and minority populations. They are trying to shut down all these scholarships. The budget cut on education directly affected the quantity and quality of education. We observe that they are not employing any teachers in the schools. Still, there is a huge vacancy all over the country, and whereas dropout rate is increasing from midday meal to higher education, from Anganwari to higher education, everywhere they are not giving money for education. So they, and at the same time, this rampant corruption in education sector is increasing, like we observe this VAPAM scam in the recent time, and there is scams on SSC SSC exams are scams on SSC exams are going on everywhere. Everywhere in each and every state, especially in the BJP ruling state, in those who are allied of BJP, these scams are going on. At the same time, you observe the exclusion policy of what BJP government. This directly affected the SC, ST and minority population. The recent NCDHR report said that the scholarship arrears has increased a huge amount in this time. And we also observed how regarding the scholarship, that a report by RBI, this is according to a report by RBI, an inflation of 28% in the last 5 years since 2013, but the scholarship is not increasing. So we demand a non-NET fellowship should be increased by at least 50% from the current session. At the same time, we also demand the regular embracement of fellowship like JRF, CSIR, ICSSR, these types of scholarship, it must increase. And at the same time, we also observed how they are targeting this MANF, RGNF, they are trying to reduce this MANF, RGNF scholarship, because they are trying to attack the, these are the scholarships for the SC, ST and minority population. Actually, they are trying to implement their Manuvadi patriarchal attitude. So that is why they are trying to stop this scholarship, they are trying to destroy this scholarship. And also what they, how they are trying to attack this higher education system. This, we believe this higher education means creative development of our country. But the tempering higher education means tempering the future of our country. So that, but and this BJP government in trying to implement the prescription of IMF, WTO, and that is why they are trying to implement the commercialization policy, and their main weapon to the using this commercialization, communalization policy through this centralization. This centralization, in the recent time we also observed this RUSA, how they are implementing RUSA, CBCS, they are trying to dismantle UGC also. These are centralization policies they are trying to implement in our education sector. Through this centralization policy, they are trying to attack the federal structure also. And lastly, what is the another danger, the most dangerous thing, that is the danger of communalization. Actually, the urge to undermine the secular democratic character of India and replacing with RSS fascistic vision of Hindu Rashtra is their policy. And that is why they are trying to change curriculum, they are trying to change the administration, and they are trying to replace history with mythology, they are trying to replace science with pseudoscience also. The Nobel laureate Amartya Sen regularly expressed his disagreement with the policies of Modi government. Actually, they are trying to destroy this education sector. So we gave a slogan that bahut ho gaya goshala, aap chahiye aap shuru chalu karo paathshala. So actually they are investing on the festivals, they are investing on cows, but they are not investing on the future of our country. These are serious thing we have to think right now. At the same time, if this is a condition of education, what is about the employment also? We students and youth, we want to work, but in the reality, that Modi government, they assured that 2 crore job per year, but in reality, in the last year also, 1 crore 10 lakh job was lost in our country. And now they are trying to divide us in the name of religion. So we gave in the last few years back, there was a convention by SFI and DYFI. In that convention, we gave a slogan, Dharam ke naam pe mat toro, nau jawano ko kaam se joro. This was our slogan, and it is still relevant right now. And we have to unite our country on the basis of this. So if it is the condition of our country in this situation, with the students community, we give a call, and SFI along with four lay student organizations, we launched a concrete struggle. And the last few years, continuously, SFI is struggling in every campuses, in every parts of our country. SFI, in the Maharashtra, we fought against the policies of this Modi government, where they are trying to shut down the tribal hostels. In Rajasthan, we fought against the policies of the Vasundhara Raja government. In Himachal Pradesh also, our comrade is fighting against the policies, centralization policies like RUSA and CBCS. In Tamil Nadu, where comrades are fighting for the increase of the bus fare, reducing the bus fare. Everywhere movement is going on. In the Bengal, there were our comrades are fighting against this autocratic government. In Tripura, our comrades are fighting against the autocratic government also. So far, this battle is going on. And in the campuses like JNU, ASU, the battles of ideology is going on. So in this situation, we gave a call on 18th March, Chalo Dilli. This is a call of the five lay student organizations, SFI, AISF, AISB, PSU and DSO. These five lay student organization gave this call. On the very next day, on the 19th February, there will be another march. This is called by JFME, Joint Forum for Movement on Education. This is also a composite body of teachers, students and parents. So all will fight together, because we believe this is not only a battle of the students. In the recent past, we also observed how the farmers, how the workers came to the streets. They fought for their rights. Recently, I visited some of the villages in the Marathawada, which is Marathawada, as you know, Marathawada Vidarbha region is a suicide capital of our country. There we also observe that how the students are suffering, how the dropout rates are increasing. From there, farmers committed suicide once. Now they refuse to suicide. They unite to fight back, and that is the spirit. The whole country is trying to fight back against the Modi regime, and that is the united struggle of the farmers, workers, students, teachers. We have to fight back. Once, as you know, in the past, during the Spanish Civil War, the leader of Communist Party, Dolores Ibarruri, she gave a slogan, La Pasiorania, No Pasaran. And now, this is also our slogan, they shall not pass. We have to unite, we have to fight back against this Modi Raj. On 18th and 19th February, students from the whole country will unite in Delhi, and we'll show what students can do. And for this agitation, now everywhere this protest is going on. We are fighting on the local issues also, on the basis of the local issues. We are raising the issues, the demands of the students in each campuses, and from Tripura to Gujarat, from Jammu to Kanyakumari, everywhere students will come. And that we are also, the thousands of meeting, we will come to this to Delhi after thousands of meeting, the small street corners, from class campaigning, we circulate thousands of leaflets in each campuses. We will our students community, because once Modi assured the student and youth to provide, he will give job, he assured us he will provide a free education. But in reality, it's a completely opposite. We demand establish a nationwide, fully state-funded and free common education system from KG to PG. We demand increase government spending at least 6% of the GDP and 10% of the central budget on education. We have to resist communalization, and they must stop this communalization politics, communalization on education sector. We demand to implement the job to each and every educated Indians. We demand also, they must ensure the proper reservation also in the existing reservation. We also demand this, to protect the federal character of education, and this government must assure to stop the gender discrimination in the campuses. With one of the major demand is there that the government must release all the money for the all pending scholarships immediately and establish more fellowship for research scholars also. So with all this demand, we'll united, the students of our country will united on 18th and 19th February in Delhi, and we believe we have to fight back and we will win.